And to take an accountant and make them a financial strategist, that's what upskilling is all about.
Hi, I'm Justin Femmer. I lead PwC's data automation consulting practice.
And I'm Jack Norris, SVP of Strategic Partnerships at Alteryx.
So today we're going to talk a little bit about automation and some of the things that we're seeing and the barriers need to be overcome to achieve automation at scale. One of the things that we're seeing across a lot of enterprises is big investment in ERP systems, not getting the ROI and returns expected from these big enterprise programs. Part of that reason is with approaches like fit to standard, less customization in ERP systems for purposes of business simplification, a lot of the end user's needs aren't actually all being solved alone with ERP systems, hence magnifying the need for downstream automation and citizen automation. So then we move forward. We have many companies realizing that and going down the path of citizen automation. Problem with that is they're not achieving scale or they're not achieving material results in a short enough time. A couple of the reasons for that are not establishing governance on the front end. So Wild West, you get some bespoke pockets of citizens achieving some success, but not in a coordinated fashion. Or you have a very centralized model where everything goes through a COE, and that doesn't scale because all the users submit their business cases, you have a bottleneck, and as their needs change, it's hard to keep up with the current state of flow. So what we're seeing companies really move forward now is a hybrid operating model, getting support for users at the beginning so that they can move from just getting through the day-to-day things in order to get to more strategic use cases. And Jack, before I talk maybe a little bit about some of those strategic use cases we're actually seeing achieved through automation, maybe I could let you weigh in on what I said, challenge me or add on.
No, I think what we're seeing is there's a business process focus that UiPath is doing extremely well. And Alteryx complements that with a data process. So it opens up the types of use cases that are possible. Use cases that provide context on what actions should be taken, opens up the types of automations that are possible, and really is core to achieving digital transformation.
Yeah, and we've seen that. We have seen UiPath and Alteryx combined, as you mentioned, the data and the process to tackle 85% of call the day-to-day use cases that a lot of departments have within a company. What's even more exciting to me these days and what we're now seeing is as companies are really launching and democratizing automation with these tools, getting through the backlog of the things that they do today, they're now moving into more strategic things like business forecasting under, you know, who would have predicted COVID and all the different scenarios and variables that might impact the economy and our business performance. We're seeing these tools be a big part of that. ESG is another huge initiative. Our firm, and I know a lot of other firms, are really big on, and how are we predicting our results or the decisions we should make around alternative energy, as an example, or investments? What does that do to our business performance, relative to all these other factors? To get to that level, you've got to have a good handle on your data and processes. In the companies that have already been down this path using UiPath and Alteryx and these types of tools to automate their data are in a far better position to layer on scenarios and forecasts and all
that. That's a great point. And it's not just about the technology. We tend to kind of focus on the technology, but the people and process that surround that to kind of identify the low-hanging fruit of productivity savings that then you can free up those important employee resources and address the more transformative top line, bottom line kind of risk mitigation efforts. That's key, and I think that's where PwC is so core.
Thank you for that softball. I'll take the basketball for the alley-oop. That's a great point, Jack. And I would say what we've seen is, obviously when we talk about citizen automation, it requires upskilling of people. And we've seen companies go through periods of training, learning a new technology, but without sort of that consistent opportunity to continue to upskill for continuous reinforcement, some of these programs have stalled out or gone flat. So, you know, one of the things that we're working with a lot of companies is access to our ProEdge site, you know, as an example.
Yep.
It's got a lot of curriculum to really reinforce that initial surge of training, keep it moving forward. We have a lot of content on UiPath. We have a lot of content on Alteryx. That's been a really big compliment to a lot of the companies we're working with having success.
You know, when we talk about upskilling, sometimes that's equated with technical training, and to take an accountant and make them a financial strategist, that's what upskilling is all about. Hey, Justin, it's great seeing you. It's been great here at the conference. It's just hard to replace being live.
It is. Thanks, Jack. Great seeing you. Really appreciate everyone's participation in the conference. We've had a great time and really look forward to seeing all these companies move forward in the future in automation.
And thanks to the UI team. Fantastic conference.